Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike.
He said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said, Take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. Then he took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And he did the same with the cup after supper, saying, This cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood. But see, the one who betrays me is with me, and his hands are on the table. For the Son of Man is going as it has been determined, but woe to that one by whom he is betrayed. Then they began to ask one another, which one of them could be who would do this. A dispute also arose among them as to which of them was to be regarded as the greatest. But he said to them, The kings of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so with you. Rather, the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like one who serves. For who is greater? The one who is at the table, or the one who serves? Is it not the one at the table? But I am among you as one who serves. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
As has been the custom at St. Philip's for at least a decade, and probably for decades before that, the traditional gospel text for Maundy Thursday is the one when Jesus washes the feet of his disciples, that act of servanthood, of being on the ground, washing the very feet upon them, and they trod the ground for the whole day before. And it has been tradition for churches across the world to have foot washing as a symbol of humility, as a symbol of signifying that we are also servants here in this world to serve others, to bring all the world to goodness and wholeness. Well, this year we have COVID-19, or the coronavirus, and among other things that we're not supposed to do is to touch people's feet, hands, faces, or even our own. And so foot washing is not something that we could do this year. And so thankfully, the ones people who put together the lectionary text for the Book of Common Prayer offered an alternative gospel text. They must have foreseen somehow that we couldn't do foot washing. And so it's the institution of the Last Supper, the institution of the Holy Eucharist, the Lord's Supper, at the Last Supper. Our lesson from the Epistle from Corinthians is the same story. And so we hear it twice to cement for us the importance of gathering at the table, worshiping, saying thank you to God, remembering that Jesus walked among us as one of us, yet was God. God with skin, as I love to say. To remember that God in Christ gave up everything for us in order that we could try to be the best people that we could be as many days of our lives as we're able to. In the Episcopal tradition, the Holy Eucharist is a central portion of our liturgy. Music and prayer and scripture and song supply and complement the Holy Eucharist. So it is, I think, appropriate in this season, this week of Holy Week, as we walk slowly through the services, to remember that on this night, when Jesus, the night before he died, that he sat with them as a servant, not as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He came to them as a servant and told them that if you wish to be the greatest, you must also be the least. It is humbling. It is powerful for us to remember that in this great church of ours, our leader came to us as an infant, in poverty, proclaimed himself a servant. And in this world in which we're living currently, in the season of COVID, in the middle of the season of Lent, what it must be like for us in our own world to remember that we can be servants to one another and for one another. That our call as followers of Jesus is to be God, Jesus' hands and feet in the world, to lend our heart to others in pain or in need, to remember in prayer those who are suffering, to remember that above all, on this night, Jesus came with the gift that has lasted through centuries, not just the act of the Holy Eucharist, the Lord's Supper, Holy Communion, it's called in different traditions, but the act of giving himself to us as a reminder and as a promise that we will live and Christ will live through us. It is a time of uncertainty, and it is a time of worry and of anxiety. We keep hearing those words and these phrases, but it is also a time of trust and of hope and of promise that the God of all gods, the God who has seen centuries and people through trials and tribulation, that God will see us through this as well. Just as God sees us and Christ on the third day, sees us through to the resurrection and beyond. We are the people that Christ has gathered. We are the people tonight to remember this night of betrayal, but also this night of gift, a promise. And may we, as we move through these next 3 days, until we come to the resurrection, remember that as Christ was with the disciples and reassured them in their worry and their grief, that Jesus accompanies us as we move through these next 3 days and beyond, as resurrected people, as people of resurrection, people who have been given great gifts and great love because of Jesus. You stand with me as we affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of God. Of one being the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, and in accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven. Seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge the baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer to the Peoples, Form 3, found on page 387. Form 3 on 387. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and the needs of others. For these Philippians celebrating birthdays this week and last week, Mary Buchanan, Bonnie Sessions, David Webb, Jessica Robinson, Felicia Johnson, Johnny Gulledge, Morgan Webb, Jennifer Hansen, Freddie Parker, Pat Seagrull, Charlie Russell, Sonny Sewell, John Buzzy, Faye Hollingsworth, Alex Siegfeld, Brian Wells, and Dan Wells. And for the Philippians celebrating anniversaries, Lolly and Bob Everett, Susan and Jean Slaughter. At this time, I invite you to pray aloud or in your heart for others that are in need of prayer. For our Philippians, Laura McGee, Mary Buchanan, Patty Clark, Steve Bell, Vangie Joseph, Jean Vaughn, Tom Crockett, Pat McLarty, Ann Harkness, Billy Kinsley, John Meyer, Judy and Don Lacey, George Morey, Mary Frances Ponder, Pam Hopkins. And we pray for our family members. We pray for those in our community. We pray for those who have died. And we pray for our military.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you from our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name.
Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, have mercy. Forgive you all your sins for our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
If you'll stand with me, please. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Walk in love as Christ loved us, giving himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Mm-hmm.
And when we have fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Jesus, I pray.
us pray. Eternal God, heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? And are so far from my cry, and from the words of my distress. Oh my God, I cry in the daytime, but you do not answer. By night is well, but I find no rest. Yet you are the Holy One, enthroned upon the praises of Israel. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? Our forefathers put their trust in you. They trusted and you delivered them. They cried out to you and were delivered. They trusted in you and were not put to shame. But as for me, I am a worm and no man, scorned by all and despised by the people. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? All who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips and wag their heads, saying, he trusted in the Lord, let him deliver him. Let him rescue him if he delights in him. Yet you are he who took me out of the womb and kept me safe upon my mother's breast. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? I have been entrusted to you ever since I was born. You were my God when I was still in my mother's womb. Be not far from me, for trouble is near, and there is none to help. My heart within my breast is melting wax. My mouth is dried out like a potsherd. My tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. And you have laid me in the dust of Packs of dogs close me in, and gangs of evildoers circle around me. They pierce my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. They stare and gloat over me. They divide my garments among them. They cast lots for my clothing. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? Be not far away, O Lord. You are my strength. Hasten to help me. Save me from the